Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is the first Monday of the month, and so of course that is our All About the Mouse Hop. And I am taking inspiration from this that I found off the Pinterest board. And also I really liked this free sketch by Allison Davis. And so I am not going to follow it exactly, but definitely got some inspiration from it. So first I'm going to go ahead and double back my picture, and I want to have the black have a little bit more of a thicker edge because I'm going to do some faux stitching around it. On the pattern paper, you'll see here in a minute, there's sort of some stitching around what I'm going to make my title. So I wanted to have a little room for that as well. So I'm going to put that picture of me right in the middle of the page. And I am going to be doing a layout about all those Disney essentials. So I have my backpack, I have, of course, my Crocs, I have my ears, I have my magic band, I have my sunglasses. There are just some basic things that I like to take to the parks with me, and I've never really documented it, and so I thought it would be fun to add a layout about that. This was actually a picture of me waiting at the bus stop on our first day in the parks back in January, and it just sort of, it was a picture that didn't really go with anything, and so I thought, well, that works. So I went ahead and took a lot of Mickey heads, and I'm going to put them around the rest of the layout. And this is where I got the inspiration from the sketch. So the sketch has a lot of little elements lined up in rows, and so I'm not actually going to line them up, but I am going to scatter them around and fill up some of that white space. I think the pattern that's on this pattern paper is enough for my title and my embellishments. So I'm just going to go ahead and line up those Mickey heads. I love, 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 love this punch. It has lots of different sizes, and I went ahead and used the rest of the cardstock from when I made my die cuts. And so I'm going to go ahead and add those around. I have these paper piecings here that I had gotten and cut files, and I really love them. If they are ones that came from Etsy stores, I will definitely link them. I believe the Crocs and the backpack and the Mickey ears or mini ears definitely did come from an Etsy store, and so of course I want to support small businesses, so I will definitely link those in the comments section so that if you are interested in them, you can definitely check them out. The sunglasses, I believe, were from Cricut Design Space, and the magic band was from another cut file that I already had, and I'm not sure where it came from, but that is that's kind of the 411 on the cut files. I know if you do a lot of Disney layouts, it's always fun to know where some of them come from, so I will try to link that for you. So I'm just going to go ahead and continue to add more and more of these little Mickey heads, and then I'm going to do just a little bit of journaling, and then I wanted to also draw an arrow to the Mickey essentials. And so I'm going to draw an arrow to the ears and the Crocs and the shades and the magic band and the backpack. So I would love to hear from you. What are some of your Disney essentials? Or if you don't go to Disney, what are some things that you absolutely have to take when you go on vacation? Some of the things that I did not add on here are the Bengay, the Advil, the Tylenol. We spend a lot of time. We probably do 25 to 30,000 steps a day when we're in the parks, and so our feet get super, super tired. I think bath bombs is another one we bring a lot, or I will get at Basin in Disney Springs, but definitely we have some real Disney essentials. So there's where I'm going to go ahead and write in my journaling. I don't do a lot of journaling on my videos. I usually do that afterwards, but I am using this fun pen from Ellie Studios and just writing in what my essentials are and why they are so necessary. And it really works with this pattern paper because it looks like notebook paper, and so I already have my lines all drawn in. And then I'm going to use my Signo Uniball pen, and I'm going to go around the edges to my photo, and I'm going to faux stitch around there as well. And that is really going to be it. I am going to add just a little bit of pixie dust from Scrap and Inks Craft around. I believe I do that off camera. That's sort of an afterthought. What I was like, oh, you know, that would be kind of cute too. So I'm going to add that on, and you'll see that in my final layout. So I did want to remind you that there are several talented scrapbookers that are participating in this hop, so make sure you check out their layouts as well and their videos. And if you like this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up. If you're not yet a subscriber, of course, hit that subscribe button, and I do appreciate when you do that. So I hope you all have a magical day, everyone. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.